Have you ever held 10-9 carbon or stainless steel screws side by side? They may look similar, besides the stamp of course, but they behave completely different. Today we'll go over strength versus style and how we use both release to create truly unique machines. Without any RTB. Yes, I said it. Hey folks, welcome back to a brand new video, and shout out to everyone who's returning and watching from Canada, US, Germany, and now India. I see we're growing more and more, which is awesome. With that said, let's jump right into it. So these are the 10-9 and the stainless steel screws, as I was mentioning before. For all our builds, I stick with M3 and M4 variants, of course in different lengths and sizes depending on the built-in configurations, as you guys see below. I'll be going over this in more detail, so make sure you stick around for that. 10-9 follows the ISO 898-1 standard, which basically means it's quenched in tempered carbon or alloy steel. The ones we use are typically around 1000 MPa of tensile strength and about 900 MPa yield. Essentially, they're built to handle like load and torque, vibration, without losing much tension at all. Now just let me explain that number there for a second. The MPa stands for megapascal, which is a unit of measurement for pressure and stress, essentially. It's how much force per square millimeter a material can handle before it just deforms and breaks down. So when you hear 1000 MPa tensile strength, all that means is it can handle roughly around 100 kilograms of pull on every square millimeter before the screw is essentially fails, or is considered failed. Now on the flip side of this, the stainless screw followed the ISO 3506-1 standard. You'll see usually grades like the A270 and the A480. The A270 is a bit more common. That one is the 304 standard stainless steel. A bit more common, that one. Still strong, still resistant. It's basically perfect for general use. We're talking like cases, brackets, panels, things of those natures. On the flip side of this, the ones that we have here today, the A480s, these ones are made with the non-standard, I call it, the 316 stainless. They just add that extra layer of corrosion resistance. They're ideal for exposed areas like humidity area, coolants, around coolant areas. You'll always see me use these particular type of screws. Both are a bit softer than the 10-9 carbon, of course, but they essentially never rust. They're very, very rust proof, and they keep that clean finish, essentially. Pretty boring topic. I'm not sure if anyone's interested in like diving deeper into ISO specs. If you guys are, I have like a go-to reference sheet that I always like to reference. It's by bigboltnut.com, so I'll leave that link below. I think they have like an archive section. I think they do a terrific job of keeping it. They keep it relatively updated as well, so I recommend you guys. They don't know who I am, but I recommend you guys check them out. Now, you may be thinking it's a bit overkill to apply these, but I can tell you, I can let you know, following in the lines of Singularity Computers, definitely you want to be using high-end quality components. It's the reason why nothing dies at Elysium. So like, I don't know if I've actually explained this, but the name Elysium Machines, so in the old Greek days, in the Greek pantheons, what would happen with the old Greek gods, they had champions, essentially, right? They had fighters. So when these champions, these fighters being service to these gods for many, many years, well, they wouldn't go out the same way as, like, an ordinary citizen would, essentially, or, someone that's not a champion of the gods. They would usually, kind of seek their fate and go through the Hades and go through Tartarus and, go through hell, basically. Now, on the other hand, the champions of the gods, they would stay in the Elysian fields. So that's where the name comes from, and essentially they live forever, that's where the name Elysium Machines come from, because, I don't want to jinx it here, but yeah, like, machines don't die around here. Elysium Machines, they live indefinitely. I have CPUs here that are 15 years old that are still in systems, like, actually doing something, being, anyways, I'm going to stop here, but yeah, I digress. Back to what I was saying, but yeah, practical application for these is, like I mentioned before, the 10-9 carbon goes whatever torque, tension, and vibration matter. So we're talking radiator mounts, distribution plates, frame supports. They bite down hard, they stay tight, and they give a solid mechanical feel and look. So you can't really go wrong with that, right? And that's in any application. In this particular case, it happens to be PC building. And then on the stainless steel, on the other hand, it's more for like, you know, visible panels, reservoirs, face plates, fan frames, or mounts, things of that nature, you know, ascent pieces, anything like that. Essentially anywhere where like finish matters and it's exposed to coolant or humidity. I say go with the stainless. You know, they hold their shine, basically, you know, rust resistant, like I've mentioned before, and they essentially look, I'll show on camera here, they make a build look refined, like even on fans, they make a fan look very, very refined, very unique. But that being said, let's jump into the polish test, which is what I really wanted to show here. Essentially, you can even do this at home. This is more made for the system builders, I guess, but anyone can really do this. It gives a really nice finish. But yeah, you will need a 4000 grit polish pad here. I usually get these in a 2-pack from our local hobby shop here. Shoutouts to Hobby Sense. With that being said, yeah, let's go ahead and start with the carb, with the 10-9 carbon. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to do it for about 20 to 30 seconds here. I'm just going to go back and forth here for about 30 seconds, and I'll go in circular motion for about another 30 seconds, and we'll take a look at the results. And you'll see that it's very, very clean shine, something you want on a screw. Pro tip on the 10-9 carbon, what you can do is you can drop like a dab of oil on there, and that will kind of just lock in, give it a little bit of oxidization protection, not much, mind you, but it will kind of lock everything in. It looks really, really sharp. Now on the flip side of this, you'll notice with the stainless steel, usually I go for about a minute to about 2 minutes. Because it's a bit more softer metal, you'll notice it does take a bit more, it's already a bit shiny as is. It does take a bit more to shine compared to the 10-9. And I just thought I'd mention that you will kind of go for about a minute or two on the stainless steel side. Now, if you're wondering why the shine is different, the 10-9 carbon is tempered titan grain. From what I looked up, it's like hardened surfaces. I wish I had enough animation skill to be able to show that to you guys, but it behaves differently. The stainless steel on the flip side has chromium in it. You know, that's where the rust resistance comes from. You know what I mean? So the light scatters differently on the surface. So I would love to show you guys that, but unfortunately I don't have the editing skills yet, but stay tuned. Those are coming. Now, the editing skills aside, and back to the rust resistance, essentially both of them are valid here. Both screws have different optics, and they're both purpose built. Not one of them is better than the other, just depends on the task at hand, I would say. But that being said, just some notes just to kind of wrap things up. Any kind of high clamp load or vibration, again, you want to go down with the 10. There's also 12.9, since you just a bit more of a hard rating. But yeah, 10.9 is the best thing that you can use for PC builds. I don't think you need anything more than that. But the torque and resistance loosening, again, 10.9, you want to go with that. If you want any kind of, again, rust resistance, if you want any kind of moisture exposure, then you want to stick with the stainless. With that being said, just want to make sure if essentially we use both, like I mentioned, we're using them both here for purpose, right? It gives a very uniform look without any kind of RGB. It gives a really refined finish, as you guys can see just by this radiator and the mount. With that being said, where did you use it? Have you guys ever just, you know, I want to get some engagement going here. Have you guys used 10? Like, have you guys used this in your build? Are you guys interested in using it in your build after seeing this video? Just let me know what you guys think. Are you guys interested in videos like this with more detail? But yeah, with that said, I'll leave it here, folks. Thanks again for tuning in. Again, drop a like in a sec. I would really likely appreciate it if you enjoy the content, of course. But yeah, stay tuned for more deep dives and hardware tests coming. You know, maybe I'm trying to be a mini gamer's Nexus. Anyways, take care, folks. Have a good day.